Good afternoon from the wine room at Oceanoni, the Twin Cities' best Italian restaurant, with now the best wine list in this part of the world. Over 1,400 wines on our wine list, with our extended wine list on the iPad that we're really excited about. I'm really thrilled to tell you about this wine today because I have a personal connection with it. A few years ago at my wine store in Nashville, a father and daughter came in. I think she was a student at Vanderbilt University across the street. And she asked for the Sofia wine from Coppola. And one of my employees told her that we didn't carry Coppola wines. The man said, "That's amazing. I can't imagine. You must be the only store in America that doesn't carry Coppola wines." And I stood up and said hello and said, "I'd be glad to explain to you why we don't carry Coppola wines if you'd like me to." And he said, "Well, I really would like you to." And I said, "Well, here's the thing. In the 40s and 50s at Inglenook, the people that owned the winery back then made some of the greatest wines in the world. And I've been lucky to taste them. And they are great today, all these years later, these wines. These extraordinary wines have a long life. They're beautiful, beautiful wines. Some of the greatest wines in the world. Francis Ford Coppola took over and decided he didn't really care about making great wine. And the one thing that's sacred in the wine industry is terroir, the land on which the grapes are grown. And if you are lucky enough to own a great vineyard and you don't bother to make great wine, that's really a tragedy. Because you can't make great wine in a bad vineyard, and you're capable of making great wine in a great vineyard, but you just don't bother. That seems sacrilegious to me. Wine sacrilege. So, of course, that's what I said. And of course, the man introduced himself to me as the vineyard manager for Francis Ford Coppola. And, you know, he didn't want to hear exactly what I had to say, but it also generated an interesting conversation, and we just agreed to disagree. Now, I know it's coincidence, but 2 years later, Francis Ford Coppola announced that he was changing the name of the winery back to Inglenook, and he was going to make great wine again. Now, I know it's just coincidence, it's not because of our conversation, but I kind of feel like I had a hand in that. And here we are, all these years later, and we have the 2015 Inglenook Napa Valley Cabernet Sauvignon. It's extraordinary. It's everything you want in Napa Valley Cabernet. It tastes like the great ones, like Colgan at $600, Screaming Eagle at $2,000, Arlen at $1,000. It's really, really beautiful wine. Majestic, powerful, dry, masculine, tannic, long life. And here's the kicker. At the winery, which according to winesearcher.com is the only retail source for this wine in the world, they sell this wine for $70. We have 9 6-bottle cases of it, and our price is $59.99. So we are actually $10.01 less than the winery for this bottle of wine, which you will be thrilled to drink. I hope you'll come by and see us. Call my bluff on this amazing wine. Thanks for watching. Cheers.